I just passed my driving exam. I know how much I spent. I spent close to £4,500 just to be a qualified. Hi, welcome back to my channel. How you all doing? I hope you all are doing great. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys things you should know how to do if you want to come abroad. Maybe you're coming for schooling, or you want to relocate to meet your partner, or you're relocating with your whole family, or maybe you're a graduate in Nigeria and just want to come to abroad to start working and earn a living. Learning these little things can help you in the long run. But before I proceed with this video, if you're watching me right now, you're new to my channel, welcome, and please subscribe and let's become friends, okay? Don't forget to click the bell icon so you don't miss out whenever I upload a new video. So one of the things you should learn if you're coming abroad is learn how to drive. If you're about to travel abroad, go and learn how to drive. Be a qualified driver in Nigeria. It's going to save you a lot of money and stress. It's going to save you a lot of time. For example, if you know how to drive, you have a driver license in Nigeria before you come to the United Kingdom, you have 1 year grace to pass the UK driving exam. You have 1 year grace. This 1 year, you can get a small car and start driving for yourself until you master the test route and you know the rules in the road. You go and write the exam with your own car, you pass. It saves you a lot of stress, saves you a lot of money. Because coming to the UK, you already know how to drive. So you don't need to do theory tests and start practicing how to drive. This is what I did not do in Nigeria. How I wish I knew how to drive before I came to this country. It would have helped me a lot. What I did was to just go and get a driver license. You know, in Nigeria, everything is possible. What's my one car driver license do? I haven't even sat in a car. I don't even know how to hold steering, but I have a driving license. So it doesn't work like that. Learn how to drive. Make sure you know how to drive before you acquire driving license. When you travel abroad, it's going to help you. Another thing you are going to learn is have something doing, something handy. It doesn't matter if you are a graduate. Learn how to barb hair. Learn how to fix phone. Learn how to do shoe mender. I mean shoe. Just have something doing. This is called plan B. For example, you are a student. You know you have, I think, 20 hours to work. But if you learn how to fix wig, you know how to braid wig, you know how to make hair, this can be helping you to make extra money to support yourself. Maybe you are in the UK and your resident permit, your right to work in the country has expired and you can no longer go to work. If you know how to make hair, you know how to do all these things, this can be your plan B. It will sustain you while you apply for another one. For example, you are a woman, you join your partner abroad. Childcare in the United Kingdom can be very, very expensive and stressful. You can be doing your part-time job, your hair, you can be sewing your clothes while your husband will be working, you stay at home to take care of the kids and you'll be doing all that, making money. Like me, I learned how to sew before I came to United Kingdom. I will not lie, it helped me a lot. I stayed at home 5 years, taking care, having my kids and taking care of them. And at the same time, doing my mini job, my sewing, making my little money, taking care of my children. So it doesn't matter if you are a graduate, because when you come to this country, doing full-time job, paying childminder, and taking care of your home can be challenging. More especially if you have a stress in pregnancy, sometimes you cannot go to work. You stay at home. So those times you are home, you are not just there. You have something you are doing, making money. That is why it is very important. As a man, have plan B. Know how to barb hair. In case something happened to your right to work, you can approach your fellow Nigerian. They can be supporting you, you barb their hair, you collect them, that small money. Your life will be going until you apply for another one. Another one is start up an online business. Maybe you have something you can be selling online. Building a website in Nigeria is very cheap to compare building a website in abroad. So start on an online something that is ongoing. As you come here, you continue doing that, you help you be making little money. If you come to this country and you decide to start selling something online, building a strong website is very expensive. Like the one I make inquiry of, I think they told me £1,500 just to build a strong website. This is the cheapest. So building that in Nigeria, I think it will be good for you. You start up an online something. Maybe you specialize in selling wigs and bags online. When you come to abroad, switching to doing those business, getting things from AliExpress, Amazon, and all those companies will be easy for you. You market it on your shop, you sell. Start up a Facebook page or a YouTube channel. These days, people are doing TikTok, where you will be linking those your website. People will be buying. As time goes on, you will grow. So these little things is very, very necessary for you if you are coming abroad. Is going to help you. Honestly, had it been I knew then, I would have learned how to drive from Nigeria before coming abroad. Honestly, it would have helped me to save a lot of money. But because I was so excited to travel abroad, I was so eager to leave Nigeria because I'm tired of the weather. I went and paid money just to purchase a driver's license when I don't even know how to drive. It doesn't make sense. It's not going to work here in abroad. Learn how to drive. Make sure you have a qualified driving license. It's going to help you in the long run, more especially you are relocating with your family. Having a car in abroad is very, very necessary for a family. So when you learn how to drive, it will save you a lot of money. I just passed my driving exam. I know how much I spent. I spent close to £4,500 just to be a qualified driver. Calculate it in Nigerian money and tell me how much it is. Each lesson, I pay £65 just for my instructor to teach me for 1 hour, 20 minutes. I spent a lot of money. I wrote the first exam, I failed. I know how much I paid my instructor just to use his car to go and do exam. So it's very stressful and you will spend a lot of money. If you are moving in with your family, learning how to drive is very important because there are some places your children want to go, activities they are doing that is far away from your house. Jumping the bus during winter can be very stressful and annoying. But when you have your own small car, you just drive to your destination. This is what I thought I should share with you guys. If you're about to travel abroad, these things may help you in the long run. Or maybe you have your family members or friends that's about to travel. Share this video with them. This video may help them. All right, guys, thank you so much for your time watching my video. Please don't forget to leave good comments. I want to know what you think about this video in the comment section. Like this video and don't forget to share this video for me. See you guys on my next episode. Bye.
The Pope takes a poop and the President too.